Welcome back to part two of A Beautiful Game. This is the Karma Rendering series, and in this part, we're looking at how to transition from Mantra to Karma. Over and above that, we're also going to be looking at how Karma compares to Mantra. We're going to be looking at what some of the greatest benefits are of using Karma over Mantra, and what has been introduced in Houdini 19 to make that transition easier. If you'd like to follow along with this part, you can open up p2_mantra-to-karma.hip. It is available in that set of files that is available for download. So once we have that file open, you should see this. We have this king geometry over here. So it's just a king that's being brought in from an OBJ. We're assigning a material to it. We have a ground plane. Then we have our material network over here. We also have a camera and two lights. So in terms of an object level scene, this is pretty common, right? You have materials, two pieces of geometry, and your lighting and camera setup. Inside of this material, there's two principal shaders, one for the king and one for the ground. So the ground is just a basic gray, and the king has a bunch of textures applied to it. Now, as many of you may know, rendering from here would usually take place through the out context. So you'd go to out, and you'd have this mantra node over here. You'd set up all of your settings for this mantra output node, and you would render to disk or render to mplay. And if you'd like to preview render, you would go over to the render view tab, choose your camera, and then say render, right? And this would do a progressive render where it cleans up each tile iteratively. And so it would bring this up and it would start cleaning up, right? So that's fine, right? That is how you would use the Mantra output node. Now, prior to Houdini 19, that was the only way that you could render from the object level, unless you had some sort of third-party renderer like Redshift or RenderMan, Arnold, whatever it may be. The only way that you would render in Houdini if you didn't have any of those was through Mantra. So we go from the object level to out and render with Mantra. Karma has been in Houdini for a little while now, but it has only been accessible through the Solaris context. And a lot of people, especially beginners, although even more advanced users, shied away from using Solaris. And I would highly recommend learning Solaris. It's an incredible pipeline tool, and USD in general is just such an awesome concept. But either way, before you would have to know Solaris to use the Karma renderer. However, now there is access to it at the out level. So from here, if we go to the out level, we also have the Karma output node. So much like the Mantra output node, we now have the Karma output node. And it has many of the same settings. From here, you would potentially want to preview your render. And you may think to go to this render view and use this dropdown over here. But with this new Karma output node, there is an extra option. As you can see on the Mantra output node, you have render to disk, mplay, or disk in background. Over here, we have those three options, but we also have this Karma viewport. Now, what Karma viewport does is it converts everything to a LOP context. You don't have to worry about it, but it is doing all of the Solaris workflow things for you in the background. So if we click Karma viewport, it'll bring up this extra window. This is the equivalent of using the render view over here, and this is your preview, right? From here, you can activate the Karma viewport renderer, and just like that, you have a progressive render that cleans up iteratively per tile. So just like that, you can now use the exact same scene and render with Karma. So it's pretty seamless going from Mantra to Karma. There aren't any settings that you really need to adjust. All of the settings that were intended for Mantra work for Karma. So in this part, I'm not going to focus on the Karma ROP output node too much. I think that it would be best to have a separate part for that. So you can check that out in part three, where we go over the Karma render output node, as well as Karma XPU. So with all of this talk about Karma, what are some of the benefits of rendering with Karma? So firstly, some of the benefits to Karma over Mantra. Karma has a much faster time to first pixel. Now, what this means is when you start a render, the amount of time that it takes for the first pixel to actually start rendering is a lot shorter. Now, that's defined by pre-render calculations, so things like dicing and displacement. And when you work in the Solaris context, you'll notice this even more. The time to first pixel is impressive. You don't have to wait very long for the render to actually begin. Karma now has much faster volume rendering. The volume rendering in Karma is currently in a great spot. Random walk subsurface scattering is also a lot better with Karma. The CryptoMat workflow is a lot more intuitive and easy to use. Karma also handles many light sources a lot better than Mantra did. And as a result, scalability with light sources is better. So you can have more lights in your scene without it getting bogged down. And of course, the overall performance is better with Karma. For example, this scene, I have set up these two output render nodes, and the mantra node and karma node both are intended to give very similar results. There may be slightly more noise in one or the other, but overall their noise levels are very similar. The mantra render took about 4 minutes and 50 seconds on my workstation, while the karma render took about 3 minutes and 20 seconds. So that's about a 40% speed increase, and of course that will vary per project and per workstation. So you can run your own benchmark with these two nodes if you'd like to test it. But really, if you want the most out of Karma, I would suggest using it in conjunction with Solaris. That is one of the major benefits over Mantra. It has integration with Solaris and USD. So those are the benefits over Mantra. But what about the benefits over 18.5's beta Karma? Of course, Karma is no longer beta. It has now been released as a production-ready renderer. As such, it is now a lot more stable. I've had a lot fewer crashes and a lot fewer issues with my rendering. One of the major introductions is the use of Material X shaders. You can now create Material X shaders, and you can check out part 4 on how to do that. Material X can be used in various rendered delegates without having to rebuild a particular material. Karma now has support for other light types, such as portal lights and IES. You can now have object name or material cryptomats. So that means that your cryptomats can either be driven by unique object names or by shared materials. There's also further improvements, like the physically based Karma hair shader. And there's a couple of other improvements. Now, I'm not going to go through all of the improvements now, as some of them are quite specific or niche. And so, if you would like to read up on what's been changed, you can visit the following page. You can look at what's new in Karma rendering for 19, and that's at sideeffects.com/docs/Houdini/news/19/karma.html. So this is the page over here, and these are the new introductions to Karma. So that's it for this part. That was just a quick overview of what's changed in Karma and how to go from Mantra to Karma. In the next part, we're actually going to be rendering with the Karma ROP output node. We're going to look at how it works, how the Karma viewport is used, and just a couple of tips and tricks as to how to optimize for using the Karma ROP output node. So, thank you for watching. I will see you in part 3. Bye.